Welcome to the next video here. We're going to discuss goals and priorities. At this point, I'm going to assume that you have decided that you have everything it takes to be a travel nurse and that you are ready to take the leap. So the first step here is to discuss our goals and priorities. This might seem like something that is not that important or doesn't deserve a whole lot of time, but let me tell you, it will definitely make this process a lot easier for you, especially when it comes to finding your first contract and understanding what you do and do not want. So to start with, we're going to discuss your goals. And basically this is your why. Why do you want to become a travel nurse? I've got listed here four very frequent common goals of travel nurses. I bet you can guess the first one. The first one is money. The financial part of travel nursing definitely can be a huge impact on your life as far as the financial benefit of being a travel nurse. Number two is the career growth. I know I've been a travel nurse for about 5 years now. I have traveled to several hospitals. I've learned a lot doing that. I've kind of found out there's several ways to do things differently, just learning from other hospitals. Third is the adventure. You know, you're traveling to different places. You're only working possibly 3 days a week. You know, you can vacation. I know that me and my wife, we have traveled to beach destinations twice during summer times, and it's been very nice working 3 days a week, basically spending 4 days on the beach, 4 days a week on the beach. So you can definitely go to other places that offer tons of adventure and life experiences. And number four is the personal challenge of travel nursing or achievement of it. That was kind of an actual big one of mine. I wanted to prove to myself that I would be able to go out on my own and travel and survive with it. So these are four goals. You might have some other goals as well. I do know these four are very common. What I'd like for you to do is take some time, really think about why am I becoming a travel nurse? Why do I want to be a travel nurse? Write them down and rank them as far as importance to you. This will be very important when you are trying to find your first contract. That way you can kind of prioritize what is important to you. So those are goals. Like I said, make sure you write them down and really ask yourself. The second part of this video, we're going to discuss priorities. Your priorities are basically what you are willing to do and what you're not willing to do. Or maybe it's what you prefer to do and what you would prefer not to do. So your priorities are very important as well. It's important to know what you are willing to do and not willing to do, like I mentioned earlier. So a lot of times what I suggest people do is get a piece of paper out. It can be the same piece of paper you've written your goals down on. Another part of the paper, make a box or draw a line down the center of that paper. And on one side, I want you to label or list things that you are willing to do and then things that you are not willing to do or maybe would rather not do. These priorities include maybe traveling to a certain location or a certain distance away from home or maybe to certain states. Maybe you prefer to work day shift over night shift. Maybe you prefer to work in smaller hospitals versus larger hospitals, or maybe only hospitals in big cities versus smaller cities. Maybe you prefer certain locations. Maybe you only want to travel in the Southeast United States, or maybe you only are willing to travel on the West Coast. Also, money can be as part of this as well. You know, is there a certain amount that you're willing to accept and another amount that you're not? Be careful with that. I don't recommend any nurse telling their recruiters their bottom dollar amount that will make them happy. But to get this focus back on your priorities, it's just very important knowing what you are willing to do and what you prefer not to do. Again, your goals and knowing your goals and priorities will definitely help you when picking your first travel contract. Travel contracts come in all kind of different shapes, sizes, qualities, colors. And then not even to mention that you can use different recruiters for the same contract. There's lots of options out there. And when you actually know the things that you are willing and not willing to do, you can start eliminating some of those options and definitely makes finding your first contract a lot easier. So, do like I said, get a piece of paper out, list your goals, rank them from highest to lowest, and then ask yourself, what am I willing to do and not willing to do? Will definitely help you when finding your first contract. So, hope this video was helpful. In the next video, we're going to talk about some of the things to help you prepare to start talking to recruiters and looking for contracts.